This video is presented by Tracks WA, Training Centre and Subacute Care. In this scenario, 63-year-old Brenda, a recent above-knee amputee, is at Osborne Park Hospital to see physiotherapist Daniel Jackson and occupational therapist Bridget Richards for some general advice and to learn about safe transfer techniques.
Okay, Brenda, so a good way of you being able to relieve some pressure when you're sitting in the wheelchair is to use your good upper body strength and pushing through the armrest to try and lift your bottom up off the wheelchair. Okay. Can you give that a go for me now?
Yeah.
Great. Does that feel okay?
Yeah, I can feel it.
You can feel it? Have another go. Perfect. And what that is doing is it's just letting the blood supply get to all of those areas in your bottom to keep it nice and healthy.
Okay.
So if you can do that regularly when you're sitting out in the wheelchair, that will just lower your risk of getting a pressure injury. Mm-hmm. Now the other technique you can do sitting in the wheelchair is just trying to bring your body forward. Have a go for me now. Good.
Yes, I can feel it changing.
Yeah, and what that purely does is just change your body posture and your position in the wheelchair. Again, just helping the blood supply get through to all of those areas. Okay? Mm-hmm. Good. So what I want to talk about is pressure care, and with the slide board, what we need you to do is be trying to lift your bottom up and over the board rather than sliding. It's a little bit confusing because it's called a slide board, so people think you would just slide on it. The reason we don't want you to do that is because of you being at risk of developing a pressure injury. Okay, so what happens when you slide on a surface, so the slide board or in bed, is that sometimes what happens, your skin gets stuck to the surface and the bones in your bottom want to move. And that causes a shearing risk and a bit of friction as well. And what that can do is it can compress the blood vessels in that area, and it can mean that blood supply isn't coming to that area enough. And what happens over time is it can cause a pressure injury.
Okay? Yes.
Now that together with you having to move in a different way now since the amputation and not having as much strength in your body to move yourself, as well as things like lying in bed for longer periods or having getting hot and being sweaty or other bodily fluids impacting, all of that combined can put you at a higher risk of getting a pressure area.
Okay.
So what we need to see when you're doing your slide board transfers is trying to push through your arms and your leg to try and lift your bottom up and over on the slide board.
Okay.
Okay? Yes. Does that make sense?
Yeah, it does.
Yep. Okay. So that's what we'll try today.
Okay.
All right.
Okay, so Brenda, what we'll do today is we'll just practice some slide board transfers onto the bed.
Right.
So if you want to just park yourself nice and close towards your right hand side.
Yep.
Excellent. Just reverse you a little bit there.
Okay.
Good. Okay, and you want to put your brakes on. And maybe shuffle your bottom a little bit forward while you've got both the armrests. Good. Okay, and we'll just take this armrest off. Okay, and we'll just take the foot plate away. And we'll use a block underneath your foot today, just because your leg doesn't reach the floor, a little bit shorter. Okay. So if you want to just lean over towards your left side, and we'll just place this board underneath your bottom. I'm just going to press it down into the pillow. Good, and then just bring that hip back down. Okay, do you feel nice and safe there?
Yes.
So you're going to pop your hand a little bit there. Don't put your fingers underneath the board. You don't want to do that. And while I stabilise this leg on the box, you're going to bring your bottom up and across and again onto the bed. So try not to slide your bottom across. All right. So I'm going to help you in your own time. Off you go. One, good. I'm just gonna position your foot again. And forward and up. Good, and then just bring this arm here. Good, and we'll do it one more time. Forward and across. And then try straighten yourself out. Excellent. Now lean over towards me a little bit and we can take that board away. Okay. Good. Let's put this bed a little bit higher to make it a bit easier. Good. Okay, can you just shuffle a bit closer to the chair for me? All right. Now, we'll just lean over towards your left side and pop that underneath your leg. Good. So that just goes over the wheel,
yes.
Okay, and closes the gap there. So okay. We're going to do the same thing again. Mm. Just take your time. Right. Let's put this leg nicely firmly on the box. Good.
Yes.
Okay. And scoot your bottom across. Good. Trunk forward. Lovely. Bring your hand across. Lovely. And maybe one more time. Excellent. And then just lean over and I'll take that one away. Well done.
Thank you.
So we'll pop your armrest back in. We'll take that block away and give you back your footrest. Good, well done.
So we'll get you to start by coming up next to the plinth. So we want your right side up against the plinth, nice and close.
Give you a hand. That's it, and I'll get you to, I'll just readjust you a little bit.
I'll get you to put your brakes on there for me. Perfect. Okay, so we're going to take the armrest off first. Put that to the side. And put your foot plate out of the way. The reason that we do that is we don't want you to be putting weight through the foot plate because it might make the wheelchair tip a bit when you do the transfer. But because your leg doesn't reach the ground, we're going to put the box in place today to help you have a bit of leverage when you're doing the transfer.
Okay.
Okay?
Thank you.
All right. So Danny and I are both going to help. I'm going to be behind you and Danny's going to be in front.
Can you, if you want to shuffle a little bit forward for us in the wheelchair, just a little bit. Good. Almost so you're just sort of clearing that wheel really. And then just leaning over to the side. I'm going to push that down into the cushion.
Don't want to catch your skin there. So we want the board to just be placed underneath nicely.
Put this up a little bit. Okay, Brenda, so I'm just going to, because your foot's a little bit numb, I'm going to support you through this leg. And then Bridget's just going to help you lift your bottom across the board so that you don't slide across this, and try not to get your fingers underneath the board. It's a nice flat palm. Okay. All right, when you're ready. One, two, three, go. Good. And I'll reposition this foot again. Lovely. And again. Good. And then I'm going to come more across over this side. Lovely. And then just straighten yourself up. Beautiful. Lean over to the side. Take that slide board away. Okay, Brenda, so we're going to get back into the wheelchair from the plinth.
Okay.
Let's pop this armrest off, put the brakes on. And we'll just pop the slide board underneath the leg.
That's it, beautiful.
Okay, so I'm going to help you with your leg again.
Okay.
And Bridget's going to help you with your bottom so that you don't slide across the board. Okay. So you can push through both hands and you're going to just lift your bottom and go across the board onto the wheelchair. Good. Up and over. Good. Up and over. So try to support yourself with your hands. Good. Lovely. And can do one more. Beautiful. And leaning across. So take that slide board out. And if you can grab the armrest. Just going to take this box away and we'll give you back your foot plate.
Thank you.
Well done. When we're first teaching patients with an amputation to transfer from the wheelchair to the bed, we always educate them to transfer towards their amputated side. And that's because we have a stable surface through their intact lower limb and a stable surface through the plinth or the bed. Once the trunk stability improves and the strength in the intact side or the lower limb improves as well with the exercises, we can then progress them onto transferring both sides, so towards the unamputated side. Realistically, in the community, you're going to be transferring to both sides, so that's definitely something that we'd address as an inpatient.
TRACS WA would like to thank the staff and management of Osborne Park Hospital for their involvement in this project. This project received funding from the Australian Government.